The range of best Sony cameras just keeps getting bigger and better as Sony expands its camera offerings to more types of shooters in areas like sports, wildlife, travel, and fashion, to video production, content creation, and vlogging. Whether you are a professional, enthusiast, or just a beginner, there is a Sony camera for everyone. Right at the top end, you've got the mighty but pricey sports-orientated Sony A9 Mark III with its mind-blowing global shutter, or the high-res megapixel monster in the Sony A7R Phi. In the middle, Sony's APS-C mirrorless cameras are a favorite of mine for travel, video, and content creation, and my current highlight is Sony's compact but powerful Sony A6700. Also, Sony's latest ZV roster of cameras is aimed at vloggers and social media creators. I love these cameras' super compact and simplified designs, meant to go anywhere and shoot great instantly usable footage with minimal effort. I've been especially impressed by the clever and affordable little Sony ZV-1F. We have listed the best Sony cameras 2024 and their key features you need to consider this to help you choose the best one for you. For more information on the product, as always, I've included a link in the description box down below, which are updated with the best prices on each product.
Like the video, comment, and don't forget to subscribe.
Be sure to stay tuned till the end so you don't miss anything. Now, let's get started.
Number 5.
Sony A6700, best value. For all the technological updates in the camera, perhaps the most significant change in the A6700 is the adoption of a second command dial on the front of the camera. This makes it Sony's first A6000 series camera to allow control with forefinger and thumb, rather than having only thumb-controlled dials. This brings the camera into line with the Sony A7 series and, for that matter, most other cameras costing more than about $1,000. The A6700 uses a BSI CMOS APS-C sensor, which we have to assume is the same one used in Sony's FX30 cinema camera. What will be interesting to see is how the performance of this chip compares with that of the 26MP BSI sensors used in Fujifilm's X-T4 and X-S20 and Ricoh's Pentax K3-3. The sensor has AF points scattered across most of its area, giving an AF system that covers 93% of the image area, up from 84% on the previous generation of Sony APS-C cameras. The new sensor shoots at the same 11fps as the previous generation of cameras, but now has the option to shoot at 11fps with electronic shutter if you want 1/8000 sec shutter speeds, for instance. We found the rolling shutter to be fairly significant if you shoot RAW, around 64ms, 1/16 sec, but significantly faster in JPEG-only mode at around 25ms, 1/40 sec, which is likely to mean a drop to 12-bit readout. The other most significant hardware change is the use of the latest Bionz XR processor, along with a dedicated processor for handling the complex AI algorithms created by machine learning. This processor combination is one we saw in the company's ZV-E1 full-frame vlogging camera, and it represents a big step forward for the APS-C series.
Number 4. Sony ZV-1F, best budget.
The ZV-1F is the company's second vlogging camera, to be built around a Type 1 sensor, but uses a wide-angle 20mm equivalent prime lens rather than the 24-70mm McQuiv zoom on the ZV-1. Despite the significantly lower price, the ZV-1F can shoot 4K video at up to 30p using the full width of its sensor. This combination of a wide lens and full width readout allows it to deliver a usefully wide angle of view, even with digital image stabilization engaged, imposing a 1.23x crop and giving an approximately 25mm equivalent field of view. A combination of cropping and Sony's super resolution upsampling allows the camera to offer a 2x zoom despite the fixed lens. The camera's 5.5K sensor means that anything beyond 1.4x zoom must be taken from an area smaller than 4K and upscaled, so you're limited to 1.5 zoom in 4K mode. The ZV-1F includes Sony's product showcase AF mode that uses face detection but gives priority to things held up close to the camera. Interestingly though, the ZV-1F does not have on-sensor phase detection, so has no inherent distance awareness. The ZV-1F needs to perform a difficult balancing act. As a lower-priced alternative to the ZV-1, some features need to be sacrificed, ND filter, RAW photography, or scaled back, focal range, autofocus performance. Whether the ZV-1F makes sense for you will largely depend on how much you utilize the articulating screen for creative camera angles and the clever product showcase mode. These features alone will be worth the very reasonable price for many. The inclusion of Sony's professional picture profiles and log video recording also mean the ZV-1F could be a great second or overhead camera that will color match with a higher-end Sony camera. Number 3. Sony Alpha 7S III for videos. Video-first creators using the Sony full-frame camera system adore the A7S series for its native 4K sensor, exceptional low-light performance, and compact form factor. The third-generation A7S III, $3,499.99, body only, ups autofocus performance for both stills and video, reduces rolling shutter, and supports 120fps capture at 4K. Along with other upgrades, there are compelling reasons to upgrade if you're still using an A7S II. Hybrid creators with a video-first mentality will be pleased with the camera's versatility, but pure cinematographers may be better served by the Sony FX3, $3,899.99. Sony's full-frame camera line is diverse. Its A7 models cater to enthusiasts and pros, the A9 series is there for high-speed stills, and the A1 is for creators who demand uncompromising performance for both stills and video, without any compromise in speed. Despite the delineation in the model lines, there's plenty of overlap in function, handling, and tech across the full-frame series. The A7S III shares its basic body design with the 60mm A7 RV and controls are fairly uniform across the line. The form factor is typical for a stills camera. An integrated hand grip and an eye-level viewfinder are included. The big difference is the rear LCD with the A7S III. It swings out to the side and faces forward, where other A7 cameras only offer upward and downward tilt. The Sony FX3 is there as an option for pure video use. It omits the mechanical shutter and EVF included with the A7S III, adds active cooling for long-form recording, and has multiple mounting points for accessories, so you don't have to add a camera cage. Despite not being an A7 model, the FX3 works with all of the same FE lenses. Number 2. Sony Alpha 7RV for photography. The Sony A7 RV is available at a recommended price of $38.99, body only. This makes it $400 more expensive than the A7R Mark IV was, at launch, itself a more expensive camera than its predecessor. Though supply chain shortages and inflation will account for some of that increase. Besides humans, the camera's AF system will now recognize animals, birds, insects, cars and trains, and aircraft. Interestingly, there are separate modes for animals and birds, as well as a combined animal-bird option. Your subject type can be selected from the main menu, the FEN menu, or a custom button. The list of subjects accessed via a custom button can be tailored to include only the modes you use. Each individual recognition mode has a series of parameters that can be modified, with control over how far from your chosen AF point the camera will search for a subject, how willing it is to refocus to other subjects, and how sensitive or tolerant the actual recognition will be. On top of this is a choice of whether the camera focuses on eye head body, just eye head, or just eyes for humans, animals, or birds. It's a frankly dizzying number of options, but presumably most photographers will only depend on one or two of the recognition modes and hence will only need to spend the time fine-tuning the way the camera reacts to their chosen subjects. All detection subjects are available in both stills and video modes. More processing power and more sophisticated algorithms offer a significant boost to the camera's in-body stabilization system, helping it deliver a rating of 8.0 EV in industry-standard tests. This has been achieved without combining in-body and in-lens stabilization, as many other brands do. Sony's system uses either in-body or in-lens movement for each axis of correction, never both together. This should mean that the higher performance is maintained with non-IS lenses. Number 1. Sony Alpha 7IV, best 2024 model. The Sony A7IV is the fourth generation of the company's core A7 full-frame mirrorless camera model. It's the most advanced yet, bringing many of the improvements Sony has made in terms of autofocus and interface design since the launch of the A7 III back in February 2018. At the heart of the A7 IV is a new 33 mp BSI CMOS sensor. This represents a move away from the 24 mp chip used by the A7 III and its immediate Panasonic and Nikon rivals. Given that BSI sensors are already widely used in the current generation of cameras, we're not expecting huge leaps forward in image quality. A slight uptick in detail and comparable low light performance is the most likely thing we can expect in terms of image quality. Despite the higher resolution, the A7IV can still shoot at 10 frames per second. However, it can only do so in the lossy compressed format if you want to shoot raw, and drops to 12-bit mode, further reducing dynamic range. The A7IV has a lossless compression option for when you need maximum processing flexibility, but the burst rate drops to around 6 FPS if you use it. Sony says the camera's buffer depth allows over 800 RAW plus JPEG images, or over 1,000 JPEGs. But this is in the uncompressed RAW format, which again shoots at around 6 FPS. Our first look at the rolling shutter rates suggests this isn't an especially fast sensor. 14-bit readout of the whole sensor for stills takes around 115 sec, 66 ms, which is around 17 times longer than the superfast A1 takes to read out its sensor. This means silent shutter mode is likely to result in significant distortion with moving subjects. Full-width 4K video takes around 27.4 min, which is comparable with the other models in its class.